Hello everyone, welcome to SpanStruct. We are going to learn how to design a steel structure in ETABS. Especially, we are going to see a truss system for a warehouses. So in the particularly exercise, we are going to take a 16 meter by 25 meter a truss systems. So the whole tutorial is divided into two parts. The first part is based on the modeling part. So we are going to model a truss system in ETABS in the first part. The second part is whole divided into two aspects. One is analysis and second is design. So in the analysis aspect, we are going to perform a different type of analysis in this, like dead and alive, wind, earthquake. The second aspect is the design aspect. So we are going to design a complete steel structure in the second aspect. So complete was the tutorial. We are going to design a truss system for a warehouse. The span of the warehouse is 16 meter by 25 meter. So if you look at the shorter span, we have a shorter span 16 meter and the longer span is 25 meter. In the shorter span, we are going to put the truss system and we are going to have a span of 55 meter in the longer span. On the basis of a span, we have different truss system. So these are the commonly used truss systems here. You can see we have a king post, queen post, fing, hui, fan. If you look at the span for the king post, you can use a span up to 16 feet. Queen post, it is 10 feet to 22 feet. And fing, it is 16 feet to 33 feet. And hui, it is 24 feet to 36 feet. In our case, it is near about, it will come, if you calculate and convert into in feet, it is going to come near about 52 feet. So what we can do here, you can see the hui, which is right now, it is a four panel, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here we can use a single hui, generally we call it, or we can say that it is a four panel, which can have a span of 24 feet to 36 feet. So here we are going to use a double hui, which will be of 6 panel. One more panel will be introduced here and here also, in the other side also. So total there will be a 6 panel. So I am going to show how it is. So you can look at, it is a double hui which is having a 6 panel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total there will be 6 panel. So these truss systems I'm going to use, and you can see here, you can use up to the span of 40 feet to 60 feet. So in our case, it is a 52 feet. So we can use it. More truss system also you can use it. I'm not restricting you to use only the dual hui only. Instead of that, even you can use that modified fan, triple fan. Generally it is a span of 44 feet to 60 feet, and also we have a many other truss system also, that is a triple hui systems. Now in ETABS, open the new model, select your display unit, make it metric SI, steel section database, you use Indian, steel design code IS 800-2007, and concrete design code you can keep it IS 456-2000. Make it OK. One pop-up screen will come. Here it is asking you to give the grid systems and the story data also. What you can do here, you can use the custom grid spacing here. You can go to edit grid data. First of all, try to understand how our grid will be. For that, look at my screen. Your grid will be one grid will be like this, second grid will be of 16 meter. And the longer span, we need to give it
at the span of 5 meter. So you can make it a grid in this longer span with 5 meter like this. So it will continue. So total, if you look at 1, 2, 3, 4, one more we need to give it. Meter. You can name this grid. You can start with ABC, so you can give AB to this, and you can name it numerical to 1, 2. This is optional. You can make it 1, 2 this side and ABC this side also. It is completely optional how you want to make it. So our grid system will look like this only, how I made it. So total it will be, if you look at a span of 5 meter I have given, so if you count it, how much it will be? 25 meter. So 1 5 5 10 15 20 25. So total, if you find it, there will be a 6 grid in this span, and this will be a 2 grid here. So same thing we are going to model in ETAPS as a custom grid spacing. You can use it a display grid data as a spacing. Here what you can do, you can give your grading a spacing here. See, you can either use this custom grid spacing also, and even you can use the uniform grid spacing also, because your grid system are in uniform way. There is no any, like, there is a span of 5 meter, there is nothing like that is coming 6 meter, 7 meter and all span. There is a uniform span. So you can use your uniform spacing also, and this you can use the custom grid spacing also, both you can use it. So for the this direction, this you can see here, we are going to make it first of all. So what I will do, I will give it a 16 meter. Rest what I will do, I will delete this. For the Y, total there will be 6 grid here. So right now it is having 4. What you can do next, you can give it 5 meter here. So last for, like, you can check it by giving a display grid display grid data ordinates. You can see that last we are up to the 25 meter, so it is okay. You can give it okay. Okay, once you made your grid systems, once you verify that the grid are made it properly or not, the spacing which you want are there or not. So in my case it is fine. You can see here we are given a 5 meter of a spacing and 16 meter of a spacing what we need it. Also you look at that, we have a and D. I have not given a B here. So what you can do, you need to change this D to B. So I will go to edit options. Here you will find edit grid systems options. You will modify these options here. In spite of giving D, you give it B. Make it okay. Okay, now it is fine. Now it comes to making the grid story systems after grading. What you will do here, you will go to edit option, you will go to edit story systems here. You will use only two story, so rest of the story will be deleted from here. So delete this, delete this. So there will be only two story, so 1 and 2. So you know the story why I'm giving here, to make a stress systems. So if you look at in elevation here, if you look at, I'm just showing you how it will be. So the top which you're looking, and from here, this I am making one story, and this which is here, it is completely, see, in this you're not going to make a complete, you're not going to bury it here. So what will happen, there will be base plate here, okay, which this column will be connected to that. So from here to here, one complete story one will come here, and one more this will come. So total there will be two story. So this from here to here I will give 1.5 meter, and here to here I will give it 6 meter. You can look at this part, 6 meter, and this I will give it 1.5 meter. So come to the taps, I will give it this 1.5, and this I will give it 6 meter. So it will look something like this. What you will do here, you go to the elevation part. See how we need to see elevation. Suppose I need to see the first one here. So you look at, we have a elevation here like this, first, second, third, fourth. On basis of grid you will find elevation. Like how it is this side, it will be continuing to another side also. So if you go and see the 3D here, and if you turn it, you will find that same thing here also. So there will be one elevation for this, and the second elevation for this. So that if you go to the elevation point here in elevation command, you will find it AB and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the basis of grid system. So what you can do, you can select any of thing. First of all, you select the first one, that will be more better. Now we are going to draw a truss system here. I have already discussed with you that which type of truss system I am going to use. Once again I will explain you that we are going to use a double hood truss system, which will be looking like this. So this is a truss system which we are going to draw in ETABS. First of all, I will draw a sketch of this truss system. So your sketch will be looking like this. So this will be a sketch of your truss system which we are going to use between a span of 16 meter. Now what we are going to do, we will define first our material. You can modify this also, or what you can do, you can add a new material from here. You can make it region India. Material type, you select steel. Standard, it will be India. And grade, you select 250 here. Now your material name with your all the property like modulus of elasticity, your Poisson ratio, your coefficient of thermal expansions and all will come here. You can change the design property data here. If you are doing the plastic analysis, then this all data you need to input the last two of it. But if you are doing only the linear analysis here, no need to change any data bottom of it. Only you need to change top of it. So this data, that is a minimum yield stress and minimum tensile stress, for the minimum tensile strength, this value should be taken by the laboratory experiment. If you don't have any laboratory experiment, you can give the default value what it is, that is 410. If you have your laboratory value where there is experiment for the tensile strength has been done here, you can use that data here. For time being, I am keeping this minimum tensile strength value by default, that is 410, and minimum yield stress value, that is 250, which we are keeping here. You can make it okay. Give it okay value. Okay. Now after defining the material property, our next thing is to define the section property also. For defining the section property, I will go to define option. Here I am finding a section property option. I will select the frame section. When I select the frame section, this pop-up will come here, which will show you that all the section which has been already defined are available here. So we are not going to use a default section property. What I will do, I will import a new property where the steel section will be of Indian standard. So for that, you go to import new property. When you do here, once again another pop-up will come here, which will tell you that which type you want, a concrete, steel composite, or any special. What I will do, I will select an I section. When you go here, you will find that property file will be here, where you can select any of your country. Suppose you are going for any American design here, so you will select any American code. So all the data of that country which will come here. Anyhow, we are going to use any Indian standards, that is Indian. I will keep it here. For default material section, I will use which we have already defined in the material property, which will be Fe250 here. After doing this, you will find that one data will come here at bottom of it. Select the first, the starting from the heavier one. Then on the basis of design, we are going to decrease the size of the I section. First I will start with the heavier size, then on the basis of design I will decrease the size of this I section. I will keep it okay. Okay. Now after defining the I section, I will define Indian standard of angle section also. For doing that, I will go to define option, section property, frame section option. In this, I will import new property option. I will select the steel angle. Once again, the pop-up will come here. On the basis of your country or region, you select this option. After that, again the material type, I will keep it Fe250 here, and I will define one angle section here. Now after defining the Indian standard of angle section, now we are going to define a box section for the purlins. For doing that, again you go to define option, section property, you will find a frame section option. In this frame section option, import new property here option, you select your box section option. Again the same pop-up will come here. Now you will select the Indian default material type, you have to keep it Fe250 here. After that, you select your section. So in this case, I am going to use ISB 145 by 82 into 5.4. You give it OK. OK. So we have defined our box type section. Now what we do, we need to assign this angle section, the I section and all. For doing that, I will take a command, that is a draw bin column command. In this, I will select the angle section first of all. So it will be ISA 200 by 200 by 225. What I will do next? I will draw this here. Okay, I will take one grid up to here. In this, what I will do? I will take mid of it. Now after defining all the material and the section property, now it's time to draw the section which we have defined it here. So I have already drawn one sketch where I shown you that how I am going to make the truss systems, that is a double hoist truss systems. Here what I will do, I will assign the same. For doing that, first of all I will take a command of draw beam options. I will select my angle section here which I have already defined here. After that I will make it this section here. While making here, I will take midpoint of this frame. Right now you can see that the midpoint is not snapping here. You need to change the snaps option. You have to go to draw option, snap options here. You select your midpoint option from here. So somewhere you will find line joint midpoint options here. You make it visual, sorry, a snap. You make it like this. After that you make an inclined here and you divide this frame. First of all, go to edit option, divide the frame options, break it. After breaking it, you divide this into three part. Go to again edit option, edit frame, divide into three frame object. You will get one two joint option. Again take this section command, draw section command, go to the join option. You make a perpendicular here. Here also. After that, what you will do? You select this. Again, go to edit option, edit frame, divide frame. Now you will not use this divide options. Top of it, you will need the middle of it. Make it apply. Okay. After that, when it is divided, you delete it. Okay. Same you can do here also. You can divide this frame into three part. There again two joint will come here. One and second here. Okay. So again take the command. You make it like this. Again what you do? Select this. Again go to edit option, edit frame, divide frame. You break it. After breaking, you delete this. After doing this, what you will do? Again take this frame with the same angle sides. You draw this. Sorry. Again you redraw this. Or what you can take? You take the reshape command here and you can reshape this. Again take this section option. Draw like this. Now after drawing the truss system, Now what I will do? I will draw the column. Again I will take the same command, and instead of giving Indian standard of angle, I will use a I-section. Sorry, when I drawn here, you can see here I have drawn up some more. So what I will do, I will reshape. Okay, so you can look at, now it is fine. Here also I will do the same. I will take the again same command, I will use the same section, again I will draw. Okay, so after drawing this complete truss system, I am going to replicate with a span of 5 meter. So if you look at 3D, it will look something like this. Now what I will do, I will select this truss system, I will go to edit option, I will go to the replicate option, and this replicate option I will use the linear replicate, and I am going to replicate on the dy, not on the dx, and also I will use a span of 5 meter. So if you go and give the numbers, 5 it will be, you will find that your all the grid systems with a span of 5 meter has been replicated. Now the next is to draw the purlins. Now for drawing the purlins, what I will do, I will use a command that is join to frame command, extrude join to frame command. For taking that command, first of all I will make joints here, and that joints will be converted into the frame, that will be extruded into frame. So for doing that, first of all you select all this and also you select this also. After selecting, you go to edit options, you will find edit frame, divide frame, you break into frame into 3. After breaking, you will find a joint here, here, here and here. What you are going to do, for the first frame, that is for the first grid, you will select all the joints here. Look at how I am selecting. After selecting this joint, what you will do, you need to extrude this. Before extruding, what important thing which we need to take it, you make your this frame, see, don't worry if it is gone, again we will do the previous selection, it will come again all the joints. You select first of all this as a boss section option. So if you will find here, you will get ISB, that is a Indian standards box type. Select this. After that you go to the previous selection option. So all the previous selected options, sorry, the selected joints came here. After that, what you will go here, you will find an option that is screwed joints to the frame options. You take this option. In DY, what you will give it? You are going to give a 5. Okay, because we are going to extrude like this, 5 meter. Okay, and this numbers, you give it 5. Apply it. Okay, so when you apply it, you can find it here. This purlin has been drawn, and also you can see the section of this purlin. You will find that it has been taken ISB, that is a steel section box type. If you keep it like ISB or sorry any other section, that section will be assigned to this. That's why I told you, know that to keep it the section which you want it here. And when you will do it, you will find that this purlin is drawn very beautifully. Roof seat. For doing that, what I will do, first of all I will select this hole. So after taking this, selecting this frame, we have an option that is a screwed frame to the sail option. So you will get it here, a screwed frame to the sail option. Again, you give it the same data, that is a 5 and 5, you apply it. So when you made it, you will find it that your seat is also has been drawn. So what you can do, you can switch off your grid systems, and you can see that your complete truss, okay, which has been made it, you can compare this truss systems with the double V which is there, which I told you that this our truss will be as a double V only. So this truss system and this system, you can see here the design with is a similar only.